जावास्क्रिप्ट, सीएसएस, कैस्केडिंग स्टाइल। तो राइट क्लिक, यू कैन सी द व्यू सोर्स, सो यू कैन सी द लाइक डॉट सीएसएस फाइल, यू कैन सी दिस कोड, लाइक यू नो यू कैन सी द कंप्लीट कोड ऑफ दिस, बट दिस विल नॉट बी हैविंग एनी बैक एंड कोड, एंड दिस इज द एच टी एम एल फॉर्म। सो द इनपुट टैग्स आर फॉर यू टू एंटर द text in the text fields, and that will be username will be stored here in a variable, password will be stored here, and when you submit, your username password will be sent to backend here. Okay, now let's play a little like about understanding about like web application test. Okay, I felt like yesterday we had some lesson 11 here, not sure. Okay, now within the lesson 10, the first page should be register.php. okay, yeah, this is the one. What actually happens in the back end when you enter these things? So these are the four important pages you need to remember, which are common for every page, every website, like registration, Now this is very important for hacker to know that what happens actually in the registration page. Whenever you enter username and password in the registration page, or sometimes they will be asking for email address, phone number, everything. So what actually happens in the back end? Like, in order to see, just like we are trying to see, like username, password, submit, username, password sent to same site, same page. Sorry, same page, because we didn't declare any other page in the actions. Okay. So now you passed the username password. The backend server took your username password on the registration page. Here, whatever you entered, it was taken. So what it is doing here for this particular sign up or registration page, it will insert the records in the database. Using what? How it will insert? First, it connects to database, then it will use MySQL query. MySQL is a database, right? MySQL database query. Which query it will use in MySQL? Insert into, because we have to insert the records in the database, right? If you take the Facebook website, you registered with a username password, but next time when you go to login page, if you enter username password, it will allow you to login, but how it will verify those username and password which you entered in the registration page? It is stored on the server. Every time when you log in, it will be verified. So now let's see how it will insert the records here. I don't want to type here and waste your time, because we are focusing only on like hardly 10 to 15 minutes of time. Okay, now register.php. Right? Since we don't have anything in the action type, whatever you enter username password, the same page in the backend accepts it. Okay. Now, see, it accepted, and then it is checking for some condition, like whether already the username and password is there or not, already if that user is there or not, and then it is inserting into the database. How it will insert into table name. It has already the table name users and username password here, and So in which database it is entering, like what is the database name, how will you see that? For a, that piece of code is not here, but if you look at here, require connect.php. If you open this, it is connecting to MySQL database and selecting a database called website. So it is storing your details in a here. This is very, very important for hacker to know that. Username is root, password blank. On the registration page, I'll try to create one username, udaydatrak1, password as password. Now this is the backend, guys. Let's this is phpMyAdmin is like, let's say Facebook will be having something like this, but you cannot access because of security reasons. Just forget, we have the database called website. In that we have table called users. We have inserted some records. We'll see that whether it was correctly inserted or not. Here we have the record. Yes, username, password. But here, password is not stored in a plain text because of just we entered this record, right? UdayDatrak1. Password is hashed. Forget about because of security reasons that we will try to discuss for sure in the later session. Don't want to confuse now. We are only focusing on backend functionality. Okay. Now you also know that, like, how it is storing in the database. Now, next time when you go to login page, when you enter username password, now what things happen here? Instead of inserting the records here on the login page, what it will use? It will check whether username password is correct. Or else we can say that to check for something in DB. Something in database. It uses select query, MySQL DB, select query. Let's check that too. Now in the login page, right click, view source, your username password will be sent to this particular page itself because we didn't give any other file name here. So which file here we are in now? index.php, right? There is no other file name mentioned here. That means it's nothing but index.php. Very easy, right? See, after submitting username password in the backend, it is accepted by using $_post, $_password, and then it is checking in. Now in which database it checks? It should check only in the database called website and table called users, which was already declared in the registration.php, right? Yes, see, the table name called users and the column names also should match username and password, like, because in while registering your username password where it was entered in this particular table, in this particular column called username, password called, these two are called columns and this one is called as table. The order is something like database, website, then table name users and then columns inside the table. Yes. Now this is the easiest thing. Now the second thing, every website will have the common scenario. Whenever you open the registration page, in the mind you should think that it is entering your records into the database using the insert query. That means it is storing inside the database. Login page is just searching, not storing in the database. Okay. change password means you are changing the password, right? Replacing the old one. That means update query. Understood? This one. Do we have something like change password in this? No. Okay. Now we use the update query. For example, W3 schools. So in the back end, query will be like this, update. So here it is showing different table name called MyGuest, but it should be for this particular website. When we talk about it, the table name should be users. Like if someone is changing the password, how will be the table name? Let's be hardcore and test it. We'll not waste time in testing, we'll just change accordingly to this particular site. Now what is that? Now I'm just seeing the parameter name. Okay, table name, update, table name is users. I just seen from the registration page. Okay, now set password equal to some, let's say password equal to secret password. Okay. Secret at 123. Where ID, instead of ID, do we have ID column here? No, we have column called username. Where username equal to Uday Datra. So with this query, what happens in the backend for this particular user called Uday Datra, which is stored in a column username, his password will be changed to secret at 123. How easy is that? Okay. So we are updating. Okay. Now got it. Profile edit page, same thing, update query only. To change the phone number, email address, password, everything. Delete page, just delete query itself. Delete. Like so your username password will be deleted from the database. That means when someone deletes his profile, for example Uday Datra, this will be completely gone from the database, so that even next time when you log in, it will not be available. So all your data will be deleted. For example, when you say Facebook chatting, everything will be recorded somewhere here in the particular column. So everything will be wiped out when you delete profile. So this is very important to become a hacker. Now you know how things are happening in the backend, like what all the queries it forms, or else you can open this particular small piece of code. You always look it, like which page is what kind of thing. Yes. Now search page, which think for 2-3 minutes and let me know like which query it forms in the backend. Let's say there is a website called, what do you say, like Facebook, and you searched for some name called Uday. Which query it is formed out of these things? Like it will check for select query, like select star from, because you are searching for something which is already there in the Facebook, which if it is there, that means it is already stored sometime before. Now you are searching means select query, like to check something in the database, right? Yes. So keep a note of this point. We understood the backend now functionality. How much time we took? 17 minutes. Okay. We'll try to understand some more things. Yes. Any other page? Yes, nothing. So I think this is the best example piece of code, like small piece of code so that you can quickly see the code and understand how things are happening. Don't worry about like session IDs, cookies. When that topic comes, I'll explain very detailed. I'll spoon feed you. Don't have to learn anywhere else. So imagine, guys, like if you spend at least 4 hours a day, like, you know, for my course on the summer holidays for just for 20 days, like you, then you will not have to regret for the next 10 years of your career. Because I have seen people with 10 plus years experience who doesn't even know the topics which I discussed today. But if you know these topics, right, you will say that, yes, I know this shit in future. Like, you will be very creative to hack into the applications. For example, if you see most of the bug bounties, most people don't report like .sql files by direct access, which I shown you below, right? Everyone is checks for SQL injection, cross-site scripting. That's very common thing. Like, there are hundreds of ways which we can exploit the system. I'll discuss with you all once I complete this 100 plus security test cases. Thank you, guys. So from tomorrow, we'll start with security test case number one. Initial lessons will be low level security issues, because I don't want to make you panic with a critical issue trying to understand harder. It won't be like that. Once I cover easy things, then your mind will be prepared to understand the tough security issues very easy approach. And I also tell you what all the tools can be used easily and how to automate all the tools at once.